30 seconds of the round, not to mention the fact that you were at a 5v3 disadvantage, now a 4v3 disadvantage, as Goga does get a frag on Moss.
Yeah, that was a good kill there by Goga. Down to the bottom of the stairs is going to be the Ella. That's Eunice. Finally takes down Shaiko. Going to be aggressive. Goes for RX. Takes him down as well. That's also Diffuser outside of Garage. It's now a 3-on-2. 60 seconds left to go. You've got T-Pex, the Black Bear. He's off of that balcony window, moving down to the main floor here. And you have Sneaky trying to look around by yellow stairs, making sure that there's no one coming around for the flank above or below.
Great vertical pressure. They have full control at the moment, but Penta still does have that wild card in Eunice. And Sneaky, eventually someone's going to have to get the Diffuser. All it's going to take, and I would imagine, we didn't see it, but I would imagine there's a Valkyrie cam spying what is going to go on with that Diffuser. And all it's going to take is another jiggle peek from Eunice.
It looks as though we saw Eunice trying to look through the drone hole. Won't spot Sneaky, but he will give away his position. There's going to be the Ella trap. As soon as that goes off, Sneaky is going to be the last one outside. He's going to be hitting that. This round will go to Penta unless something drastic happens here.
They were actually successful the last time they went here, which forced them to go to Hookah where they weren't successful.
Ooh, and there's Goga getting a little bit overzealous here, and Shaco is going to pick up the frag onto him. No, he actually got picked back up by the Doc. Wonderful placement. There's Eunice. Grabs a double onto Shaiko and Moss too. And that is going to be the kills that Penta needed to possibly take this home after round number 9.
Eunice is going to come up, or Eunice is going to wait as T-Pex comes up. And he's going to pop up, and he's going to get a third kill for Eunice.
There it is. Now, on the windowsill is going to be RX. Now, he tried to get the window opened up. He tried to get the wall opened up. He didn't actually see Eunice tucked around by the sofa couch. And so, therefore, that means that's going to be, like you said, that third kill for Eunice. 5-on-2, still 60 seconds left to go. B-Genius has got to be sweating bullets right now and also needs to be shooting some bullets to try to get Penta down.
They have the Diffuser at the top of the stairs. Eunice knows where it is. It's really incumbent upon these last two operators to get a frag or two before they push it, because they're just going to stick there. You see Fabian has now moved up to back up Eunice just in case. They know that they have to come from this direction.
There's the pre-fire from Sneaky. Grabs it onto Fabian to start off the round. Bottom of the stairs is where RX is going to come up. Sneaky is going to move on over. They've now gotten away from the Diffuser. They're just playing back a little bit closer onto site, a little bit more concise. A 4-on-2 now, 30 seconds left to go. You've got KS and VIP. RX is going to try to move in forward. Pengu snags one. RX is going to be last man alive. He grabs one. He's got three more to go. Moving on to the side, and Eunice will get a 4K for the round to win the series for Penta Sports.
What a round for Eunice to come alive. Did so well, was top fragging all day, and this is when they needed it the most. Penta, a great hold. Those first two kills were crucial, and the champs don't go out in the first round.
Not a typical pick. Rook kind of fell out of the meta around year one, season three. Right now, he does have a little bit of traffic going outside of his window. Eunice gets the first frag, though, of the round. That's going to be the Jaeger taking out Taylor.
Yeah, that's Taylor. That is one of the better players basically from the entire region seeing a fall here. But Eunice is doing a fantastic job holding admin office. Now, the plan in Mantis FPS's head is to move into the top floor and from there try to just push away all of these roamers and then try to push onto the site whilst having line of sight from the top side. However, Penta are completely ready for this.
And Fiber corner office. We've seen Eunice actually secure an ace in this exact position before. And it looks as though he's still going to hold down the fort. Goga's trying to challenge someone on top of the printer window here. And Fabian still waiting underneath for a little lapel inside.
Oh my god, what a spot from below. And Eunice will be able to get kill number 2. Now spots the second one here. Will be able to finish him off. And well done, Eunice. Already 3 kills for him. Fabian will slay one, but finally falling down in Nalo.
And Nelia, though, will grab Fabian. KS picks the final frag on the round. Penta coming out with a very strong first round. They're going to head over to defense now.
Get away safely. Right on the other side of, who is that? That is Safiz. There, Safiz going to toss in, and it looks like a couple shots going in. Eunice tags one down. Can he get another? Oh, he's going to drop shot and pick up a 2K. Goga got downed earlier on by a nade, and now that might be a 3K here as Eunice has just initiated one of her mines onto Jack, who's inside of the admin. That's going to be a 3K for him. Wonderful holding down the fort here inside of the admin building. We've got two attackers left. It's all up to Kaoxy at the top of Circle Stairs and Voy on the very top of the consulate.
That was some great play by Junos. I like how he used the mine to cover his flank. He stunned himself a little bit, but that gave away there was someone on the other side of it. He's really using those smartly, and that's why he got away with 3 kills in a tight spot like that.
Wonderful job. I don't even know if he got hit with any bullets. He's looking like he still might have full health here.
Yeah, he dived into a dead body mid-drop shot, and I think that took some of the bullets for him. God bless those dead teammates.
Now, we do have Voy that was on the windowsill. He got off. He's going to go underneath, most likely, head into Visa. But he has to regroup with Kayoxy.
He's low on health as well. Not that it matters.
With a 4K here. One more member to go, and it's going to be Voy, top of the circle stairs. And I think Yunus already knows this. He's going to go for a peek. He's going to grab the ace. What a start for Penta Sport.
Yunus has always been a little up and down. Sometimes he has some excellent performances.